Welcome to the Storage Spotlight session for Persistent Disk. My name is Reuven Hess. I lead the product team for block storage in Google Cloud. Today, we have some very exciting news for you. We'll start by covering some recent and new future launches for Persistent Disk. Then we'll take a step back and cover what we see as the potential for block storage in the cloud. And then we'll have a look at addressing these areas with our next generation of block storage. We've been rolling out various improvements for Persistent Disk, but there are three launches that we're particularly excited about. Together, these three launches greatly improve the performance for Balanced PD, PDSSD, and Extreme PD. We're introducing a predictable performance floor for small SSD-based disks. Balanced PD gets a minimum of 3,000 IOPS, and PDSSD gets a minimum of 7,000 IOPS. For the large number of workloads that have only minimal capacity needs, this leads to substantially better performance. We also are increasing the maximum throughput for Extreme PD on N2 instances. Workloads on N2 instances can now benefit from up to 4 gigabytes a second of read throughput and 3 gigabytes a second of write throughput. And thirdly, we increased the performance for the regional persistent disk for SSD-based volumes by over 65%. These regional persistent disks now have read parity with zonal disks and over 2x the maximum IOPS on the write side. This drastically improves the performance for workloads relying on regional persistent disk for high availability, especially databases such as MySQL and Postgres. While we're happy with the way persistent disk has evolved over time, we've also taken a step back and thought a bit about what block storage for the cloud would really look like. Customer conversations, three areas quickly crystallized. First, ideally block storage should be dynamically provisioned, both in terms of performance and capacity. And both performance and capacity should ideally be decoupled from instance type and size as much as possible. When workloads requirements change, you need to be able to adjust dynamically. This block storage would address the full price performance spectrum. All core workloads should be covered, and for a particular workload segment, the approach should not have to vary depending on scale or other parameters. There shouldn't be an efficiency or TCO cliff when workloads go beyond the common range. And finally, the storage should be managed at scale, with the ability to manage storage in aggregate across disks and workloads, especially for capacity pooling. And with policy-based management, allowing you to set rules allowing to ensure consistency across instances and disks. And with workload awareness, allowing you to set performance requirements in the workload's context. Following these insights, we set out to build Google's next generation block storage, and we're now introducing Google Cloud Hyperdisk. Google Cloud Hyperdisk will allow you to easily and dynamically tune storage to the workload, bringing with it dramatically better efficiency and ease of use. To bring these capabilities to you, Hyperdisk is an entirely new portfolio of block storage. Three volume types cover the full spectrum of requirements for network-attached block storage. First, balanced is our general-purpose volume type, the best fit for most workloads. It covers a broad range of workloads with up to 150,000 IOPS and up to 2.4 gigabytes a second of throughput. Above it, Extreme covers the premium space, focusing on the highest performance databases with explicit performance SLAs. And below it, throughput is targeted at scale-out analytics and other throughput-oriented, cost-sensitive workloads. You can dial throughput separately from capacity, tuning volumes to the exact temperature of your data. For all SKUs, performance is fully decoupled from capacity and much more decoupled from instance type and size. Capacity and performance are provisioned separately and can be changed dynamically. And we cover a broad range of capacity, up to 1 petabyte per instance. All will be available for Compute Engine as well as GKE. And all SKUs can be added to storage pools to benefit from aggregate resource management and capacity pooling. We're excited to be bringing Google Cloud Hyperdisk to you soon, starting with preview later this year. Let's have a look at what this will look like for specific workloads. This is a case study of what it might take to size an instance and storage for SQL Server instances. Today, constraints on how performance and capacity management work lead to a complicated balancing act when you try to meet the requirements for a specific workload. I'll spare stepping through the details, but this is even more painful than it looks. Capacity and performance sizing frequently takes weeks, and you need to have a detailed understanding of the workload to do this well. Finally, mistakes can be costly and can require downtime to fix. Hyperdisk allows you to tune performance to the workload without instance restrictions, and you can size capacity freely, having actual usage determined by consumption without excessive planning and hardcore gymnastics. And performance can be changed dynamically at any time. This leads to drastically simpler deployment and management and far more efficient use of resources. Finally, you have the ability to adjust at any time if your requirements change. Thanks for attending. We're really excited to share the news about Hyperdisk. Up next, Vijay will present a deep dive on protecting your most important databases.